have, we're going to begin with our opening hymn. We'll stand and sing our opening song.
Because you were forsaken, I'm accepted, you were condemned. I'm alive and well, and your spirit is within me, because you died and rose again. I'm forgiven because you were forsaken, I'm accepted, you were condemned. I'm alive and well, and your spirit is within me, because you died and rose again. Amazing love, how can it be that you, my King, would die for me? Amazing love, I know it's true, and it's my joy to honor you. All I do, I honor you. You are my King. You are my King. Jesus, you are my King. Jesus, you are my King. Amazing love, how can it be you, my King, would die for me? Amazing love, I know it's true, and it's my joy to honor you. In all I do, I honor you.
We begin remembrance of our own baptisms in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise.
Make haste, O God, to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me.
Hear, O Lord, when I cry aloud, be gracious to me, and answer me.
Teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me out of my path.
I believe that I shall look upon the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Wait for the Lord, be strong, and let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord.
Let us now confess our sins to God, our Father. Strengthen us, Lord, and grant us your forgiveness.
We confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean.
We repent of our many sins,
those known to us and those unknown to us. Create in us clean hearts, gracious Lord, and put new and right spirits within us, that we may know the fullness of your love and be at peace with all people. Grant that the Holy Spirit guide and direct us into new opportunities for growth in Christian learning and strength in faith.
By grace you are known and loved by the one eternal God who wills all that is best for you. Through the suffering, death, and resurrection of his Son, Jesus Christ, he's brought about the forgiveness of your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ who sets us free, I forgive you all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord strengthen you with power through his life-giving Spirit, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith.
White as snow, white as snow, though the sins were as scarlet, Lord, I know,
Testament reading is from Genesis, the second chapter. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him." So out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every bird of the heavens,
and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all livestock, to the birds of the heavens, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found a helper fit for him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." And the man and his wife were both naked and were not ashamed. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The epistles from Hebrews chapter 2. Therefore, we must pay much closer attention to what we have heard, lest we drift away from it. For since the message declared by angels proved to be reliable, and every transgression or disobedience received a just retribution, how shall we escape if we neglect such a great salvation? It was declared at first by the Lord, and it was attested to us by those who heard, while God also bore witness by signs and wonders and various miracles, and by gifts of the Holy Spirit distributed according to his will. Now it was not to angels that God subjected the world to come, of which we are speaking. It has been testified somewhere, "What is man that you are mindful of him, or the son of man that you care for him? You made him for a little while lower than the angels. You have crowned him with glory and honor, putting everything in subjection under his feet. Now, in putting everything in subjection to him, he left nothing outside his control. At present, we do not yet see everything in subjection to him, but we see him who for a little while was made lower than the angels, namely Jesus, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. For it was fitting that he, for whom and by whom all things exist, and bringing many sons to glory, should make the founder of their salvation perfect through suffering. For he who sanctifies and those who are sanctified all have one origin. That is why he is not ashamed to call them brothers, saying, 'I will tell of your name to my brothers. In the midst of the congregation, I will sing your praise.' And again, I will put my trust in him. And again, behold, I and the children God has given me." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my path. My word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my path.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 10th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Pharisees came up and, in order to test Jesus, asked, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife?" He answered them, "What did Moses command you?" They said, "Moses allowed a man to write a certificate of divorce and to send her away." And Jesus said to them, "Because of your hardness of heart, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate." In the house, the disciples asked him again about this matter, and he said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." And they were bringing children to him that he might touch them, and the disciples rebuked them. But when Jesus saw it, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of God. Truly I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a child shall not enter it." And he took them in his arms and blessed them, laying his hands on them. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
See, no children no here. Children. We're all children of God. But at this moment, we're going to continue.
Amazing love that welcomes me, the kindness of mercy that bought with blood wholeheartedly my soul undeserving. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good. Behold the cross, age to age, and hour by hour. The dead are raised, the sinner saved, the work of your power. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good. Favored, anointed, filled with your power for the glory of Jesus' name. I am blessed, I am called, I am healed, I am whole, I am saved in Jesus' name. Highly favored, anointed, filled with your power for the glory of Jesus' name. And should this life bring suffering, Lord, I will remember what Calvary has bought for me, but now and forever. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. I am blessed, I am called, healed, I am whole, I am saved in Jesus' name. Highly favored, anointed, filled with your power for the glory of Jesus' name. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to
grace and peace from God our Father, from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
either way. Should we pay taxes or not pay taxes? There were government officials waiting to arrest him if he said don't pay taxes. The crowd was ready to stone him if he did say pay taxes to a foreign pagan government. Here the same thing. It says there are just the Pharisees there, but they're probably the scribes. Usually the scribes and Pharisees went together. And the scribes, I don't know why they translated it in scribes, but it's lawyers. They're people that wrote up legal documents. That's the very definition of a lawyer. The lawyers and these Pharisees there. And they asked them one of these trick questions. Is it legal to divorce? Well, what did Moses say? Moses said you could. And Jesus doesn't get into is it legal. He doesn't go down their path that they're trying to lead him down. Instead, he gets back to what was God's original intent for marriage before the fall into sin. And sin, I've said it before and I'll say it again, sin is one of those church words. Probably should be translated self-centeredness. I call it creamy. begins with the confession and absolution. I'm sorry, God, I messed up again. I've sinned in thought, word, and deed. Forgive me. And hearing God say, I love you, my child, I forgive you. And you know, that's the number one thing that helps relationships. I'm sorry, and I forgive you. Both ways. Both husbands and wives need to take turns saying, I'm sorry, and take turns saying, I forgive you. And then, this helps in our relationship with God. And there's also the two-way communication, having to take time out to listen. We're all busy. It isn't just snow out there keeping people away. There's plenty of other things to do. But taking time out to listen to God and taking time out to talk to Him. Prayer and worship. You know, for couples, it's so important. My wife and I got married, we're just teenagers. And 19 and 18, and we made it a priority to go out on dates every week. To spend time together and to talk and to do something together. Because it's so important to have set aside time and build it, and that way you can There's also, in the worship service, this intimate mystery called Holy Communion, where God comes to us in with and under the bread and the wine through word and sacrament. There's this intimate union between the husband and wife. And this was God's intent for marriage, that there be an intimate union, that we love each other till death do us part. But there's also, as I said before, the reality of a broken world we live in. There's several Greek words translated to the one English word love, and one of them is the word phileo, where you get the word philanthropy, loving others or the needy, helping the needy, philanthropy. There's another one, eros, where we get the word erotic. I don't need to go into detail on the meaning of that word. And there's another one, agape, which is a sacrificial giving of oneself for the needs of others. The very definition of this was the cross. Christ giving his very self for us. That's the word used for love in our relationships with each other, as spouses, and marriage. Love one another. Husbands love your wives. Wives love your husbands. The sacrificial giving of oneself for the other. Forgetting about ourselves and seeking to take care of their needs, not wants. And it gives us a little glimpse of our relationship with God and how He's done everything to provide for our needs, body and soul. And He's helping us, as we experience that love, we're able to in turn love others as He loved us. May He continue to reveal his love to us, and may we experience that, and in turn share that, not just with our spouses, but the sacrificial giving of ourselves for others' needs also. Amen. Now may the peace of God, who passes all human understandings, in your hearts, your minds in Christ Jesus, life everlasting. Amen.
We rise for prayer. We pray for the church, that God's people live confidently and never neglect the salvation won by Jesus Christ, but joyfully share the message of salvation in word and deed. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the nations of the world, that the presence of Christ be experienced everywhere around the globe, and that the gospel message have free course in every land. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our families and for those who share in our Christian fellowship and join with us in worship. Grant that we never take them for granted, but help us to encourage the labors in which we work together to the glory of God. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear
chronically ill and all those whose needs are not known to us. Especially, O Lord, we lift up to you the family of Don Plank and Ludwig's stepfather, mourning his loss. The family of Carl Braun, the family of Pastor Ken Feeler. Lord, grant them your peace and your presence. Be with those who are suffering physically, Jerris Freeman, Jessica, Jan Barker, Leroy and Nancy Bernhardt, Randa Pettyjohn, Naomi and Emily, Lorna Wright and Kelsey, Aaron Carlin, and others, O Lord, that we name in our hearts at this time. Lord, you are the great physician of soul and body. We entrust these, your servants, into your hands. We also lift up to you the families and staff at Open Arms and our efforts at calling a new co-director for Open Arms, that you'd guide us in this process and raise up someone who will be able to come and serve. And Lord, we also give you our thanksgiving and praise for Eddie Johansson, who experienced a speedy recovery. Good news from the doctor, for Kathleen Gertis. Thanksgiving for my wife's sister, Andrea, who's now home and doing well. Many more things, O Lord, to give you our thanksgiving and praise for. Lord, we grant that we bring your blessing to situations of need in all places. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And as we bring our prayers to you, Lord, we remember the faithful Christians whose earthly lives have been completed, who now are in your eternal keeping. Help us to follow their examples of faith and faithfulness, and at the last, reunite us with them in the joy of your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. These things and all else that we should have asked, grant to us with your blessing for the sake of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
We share the peace of one another.
Now may the true body and precious blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen, preserve you steadfast in the true faith, life everlasting. Go in peace. Amen.
We give thanks to you, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through this solitary gathering. And we implore you that of your mercy, you would strengthen us through the same in faith towards you and in fervent love towards one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
help you up. I'll help you up. And let Leslie Kerbal, come on. But Leslie was, she's on the church council, and we wanted some gray hair and wisdom. And I'm getting a few gray hairs, but Leslie knew me back when I was a teenager. And but anyway, you missed that installation. I wanted to make it. It's a community thing. I mean, the congregation recognizing this. But in the Lord, Holy Scripture admonishes us that all things should be done decently and in order. To that end, the Constitution and bylaws of this congregation establish various offices to which men and women are elected and appointed to serve. And so doing, the church follows the example of the early church, as described in Acts chapter 6. The 12 summoned the full number of the disciples and said, "It's not right that we should give up preaching the word to serve tables. Therefore, brothers, pick out from among you 7 men of good repute, full of the Spirit and of wisdom, and we will appoint to this duty. But we will devote ourselves to prayer, to the ministry of the word." And the Apostle Peter writes in his first epistle, "As each has received a gift, use it to serve one another as good stewards of God's very grace. Whoever speaks is one who speaks oracles of God. Whoever serves is one who serves by the strength that God supplies, in order that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. To him belong glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen." Leslie has been elected to serve as a church council member, and you've been chosen to fill a specific office and position of responsibility as an evangelical Lutheran church. You're to work with the pastors that are life together in Christ may be orderly and pleasing in his sight. You are to see that the services of God's house are held at the proper times, that the word of God is purely preached and taught according to the Lutheran confessions, that the sacraments of Christ are administered according to his institution, and that provision is made for the Christian instruction of young and old, that the erring are admonished and that discipline is maintained. You are to see that the temporal affairs of the congregation are properly administered, and that proper support is provided for the workers of this congregation. You are to assist in caring for the poor and the sick, in cultivating harmony among the members, and promoting the general welfare of the congregation, and in furthering the kingdom of Christ here and throughout the world. While holiness of life and obedience to Christ are expected of all members of this congregation, it's especially important that you, as office bearer in his church, show yourself by word and example to be faithful to him in service and Christian devotion. In the presence of God in this congregation, I therefore ask you, do you accept the office entrusted to you? And do you promise faithfully to carry out your duties, trusting in the Lord and conforming yourself to his word in accordance with the faith of the Evangelical Lutheran Church? If so, then answer, I do.
I do.
Beloved in the Lord, you have heard the promises of faithfulness spoken by Leslie, whom you've elected to serve as congregation chairperson council member. Do you promise to support her in her work, to remember her in your prayers, and to work with her to the best of the abilities that God has given you, so that he may be glorified in his work done in our midst? If so, then answer, we do. I install you as officer of Zion Lutheran Church in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Almighty, most merciful God, enlighten and strengthen you in your office, that you may be good and faithful steward to the glory of his name and the good of his people. Amen. And we pray, Lord God, Heavenly Father, we give thanks that you have raised up a servant for work among your people, and we humbly implore you to grant him, by your Holy Spirit, those gifts needed for the faithful carrying out of the task. Most especially wisdom, strength, and a willing heart. Let your blessing rest on this congregation. Strengthen the faith, quicken the love, and enkindle the zeal of its members, that your name may be glorified, and that here and in all places under heaven the kingdom of your Son may be advanced. We remember with thanksgiving those who have faithfully served your people and have now completed their time of service. And we pray that in the end of days, we, with all your faithful people, may hear the voice of Christ saying, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father,
the foundation of the world. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Go in the name of the Lord, be steadfast and immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. The Almighty and most merciful God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you. Amen. Thank you, Leslie, for serving. We're thankful for all those who have served and will serve and are serving on the church council. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you his peace. Amen.
We sing our closing hymn.
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever. For he's good, he's above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, his love endures forever. For the light has been reborn. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever. Forever. From the rising to the setting sun, his love endures forever. And by the grace of God, he will be reborn. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever. Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever, forever.
If you didn't notice, we don't have our lead guitarist here tonight, and she wasn't able to make it in tonight. Liz, and we do thank Dave for playing the bass line and bass on the guitar, and we didn't know what to do, and Cody and Matea for coming in. Imagine, you guys spared the congregation for me having to be lead singer. So thank you. I can't say thank you enough. We have so many, musicians, Bridger back on the soundboard, and others that volunteer around here. Thank you, everyone. There's no way this can be done. It's not a one-person show, and it's meant to be that way. A church is a team effort. Go in peace, serve God and your neighbor.
Thanks be to God.